afternoon, everyone. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show, and today is Thursday. And today what I want to do is I want to show you a very special plant to this region, to the region of the Andes. And you may know this plant for its more dubious purposes, but we're going to show you some of the you know, we're going to give you the real deal when it comes to this particular plant. And this plant is actually called the coca plant, or the coca leaf is what you see here. And it grows in a bush, and the bush generally gets about maybe no more than about 6 feet tall, so no taller than me. And this is what the leaf looks like. And the bush has multiple leaves like this, as any bush does. And this is a really special plant to the people in the Andes. It's a plant that... All right, so now you're focusing on me. Okay. Mm-hmm. And so this is a really unique plant to the people who have, you know, traditionally lived and natively lived in the Andes. And it's used for many spiritual type ceremonies. I'm going to show you you know, a little bit of the spiritual side of it, but I'm also going to show you the nutritional side of it. And I think this is one of the keys to some of the health of some of the native people here. Now, as you know, some of the native people here are having problems because of westernization of the foods and culture. But a lot of the native people are still chewing these leaves, and they're having some incredible health benefits, and maybe this is one of the reasons why. So I did a little bit of research with coca leaves, and if you look at, say, maybe I'm going to make sure I don't spill all these, but if you were to take a gram, which is about what you'd find in a tea bag, it's probably about this much, and this is about as much as you'd make into a tea. You can actually just put this into, you boil some water, and you just drop these leaves into the water, and it works fine. Sometimes you can see it ground up, but this is how it works. Or what you can do is you actually can chew these leaves and put them up in the side of your mouth right here, just as you would if you were to chew some tobacco or something like that, except it's not anything like that. So in this amount of leaf right here, coca leaves, there's about 18 milligrams of calcium. Now, if you were to take 1 gram of milk, you would find 1.2 grams of calcium. So, I mean, that's... If this is a gram, I don't know exactly how much of a gram is. You know, I really don't know, but this is just about as much as you find in a tea bag. Maybe it's a little more, maybe it's a little less. But this is about as much as you would chew. And a gram is about as much as you would chew. There is 18 milligrams of calcium. Okay? Now, if you were to take a gram of milk, which is, you know, a very small amount of milk, there's going to be 1.2. I'm giving milk a little bit more props than it should. 1.2 grams of calcium. So this is incredibly high source of calcium. This has incredible amount of calcium. I'm having trouble saying that because I'm so excited about it. But you can't buy this in the U.S. because it's illegal. Because if you have 300 grams, you can make 1 gram of cocaine. And you also need to have kerosene, alcohol, gasoline, acid wash, and a whole bunch of other things to make cocaine. So, you know, the way that this is all working out is absolutely ridiculous. But they're incredibly nutritious. It also has phosphorus, magnesium, and potassium. And what they use this for, besides spiritual type ceremonies, what they use this for here in Peru is if you come up here to Cusco particularly, it's about 10,000, 11,000 feet above sea level, they use this for ease the symptoms of soroche, which is altitude sickness. So headache, dehydration, it actually opens up your capillaries so the blood can actually get to places where it needs to go so you can, you know, feel better, you know, when you're up here. And if you've ever had soroche, you know how it feels, altitude sickness. It's not really pleasant. On the spiritual side, what the Caro do is they make a coca quinto, which is three perfectly formed coca leaves, which I've picked out three here. And what you do is you hold it like this, and I'm not going to do the whole ceremony because I'm not, I really don't feel like I'm authorized to do so. But you hold it like this, and you basically make an offering to Mother Earth, and you pray, and you blow on the leaves like this. And you feel the air, and it grounds you and connects you to Mother Earth. And I'm sure there's more that I don't know, and I'm learning, so I'm not going to give you any more. And then once you're done, you can either pass it to a friend, like you guys. Here you go. Or what you can do is you can chew them. And what you do is you chew them, you put them up in the side of your mouth, and then you're good to go. Now, you do have to be careful if you buy your coca leaves in the market in Peru. If you come down in Peru and you want to try these guys out,
do have to be careful because, you know, some of these may be just sitting around someone's farm and with llamas and alpacas and sheep and everything walking all over them. So you do want to make sure you get them from a good source, or if you even can, you can wash them or drink them as a tea. But again, traditionally either a tea or chewing them. And this is truly one of the reasons why I feel that a lot of the native people here at Chucoca have really strong teeth, because they're getting literally this mineral explosion, particularly with calcium, as they're chewing these incredible leaves. So, the coca leaf, you'll never find it in the U.S. I you know, at least in our lifetime, you'll never find it, just because of the politics about, you know, who's providing the coca leaves. Are they doing it for cocaine, or are they doing it for you know, just a crop, just the actual full crop? But you'll never find it. But if you come down to Peru, you can get these coca leaves. You can explore them. You can experiment with them, and you can really kind of get this get what this incredible food is all about. Herb, food, both. Your question of the day is: have you ever tried coca leaves? Here you go. Go ahead and post it down below. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show. Together we can change the health of the world, one show at a time.
What's important, and we're going to teach you the details of how to use a coca leaf in the Andes, and when you come back, or you can go right into it. But when you go back to your place where there are no coca leaves, you just carry that, not just the message, but the method, without the coca leaf. And this is what you're going to do. You're going to take your three coca leaves. You're going to put them... When we give you your own coca leaves, you're going to find the quinto first, the most beautiful and perfectly shaped and more or less the same size leaves. Put them all to the same side, not back to front, up to down, all together. And then they can be like this, or they can be like that, but not like, you know, like that. You know, nicely formed together. And then take those three in your fingers and perform the fuku, the blowing of the fukuriti, the blowing of your breath onto those leaves and making that connection. So he'll demonstrate again in a minute, you want to feel your breath across the edge of the leaves. And that movement. Sometimes we go a little bit higher like that. And so that so your breath is there, and it's a communication system. It's part of that synchronistic connection of nature, the spirit of the nature, and the human. And that's how we get their attention. And then we say this, and we're going to teach you how to pray over these next several days so you can carry that in your heart. The first thing is, as you remember the sacred earth, Pachamama. So, sacred Mother Earth. Pachamama, I'm sitting here, you know, on you. I'm standing here on you. You know, I'm here. And then you say to the apple that's the closest to you, to draw that energy from the apple. Now that which is above the earth, connected to the earth, but above the earth, and very powerful entities, and that come in your dreams and things. So first the Pachamama, acknowledging the sacredness of the earth. Second, connecting with the spiritual powers of the mountains and asking them for their blessing, for their protection, and anything else that you might want. But that's enough right there. You know, here, you know, there's so many mountains, you have to name them all. So you hear us saying, you know, Apu Asangate, Apu Pachatusan, Apu Sacsayhuaman, Apu this and so many of them. But you won't remember those, you know, right away. So you just think that little by little. You know, what's your connection? When you have your mesa, then that connection will be with that particular mountain that we're going to connect you with. And so it's important, and Sebastian said is, well, don't forget, you know, everybody else in the family.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's the basics on how to do it correctly. So.